Last time we showed you registration and we talked a little bit about the T-bar system, we probably didn't show you enough close-ups to actually get a good idea of what that looked like. So what we do is draw some vertical lines on the top and bottom of your paper and try to get those centered. So get a good shot of that bottom, Spencer. Okay, and then what we do is we build a registration board, and what I want you to do is get a good shot of this and also that, if you can. The reason we do set this up is because this is called a T-bar system, and we want all our blocks to register with each other. We want the master block, which carries all the information, and is usually printed last and is usually a darker ink, probably black, and we want that to register with our color blocks. So what we had done was set this in here, and we had taken a sheet of paper and that had been marked. So get a good top and bottom view of those lines, and the top is called the T, and you can see the very heavy horizontal line, and so that has to be perfectly aligned with the top of the paper. If you want to be really technical, some people like to cut that deco off the top there so we can see an exact alignment. Then come on down here, and this is our bar, and you can see that the paper could go this way or go that way. What you want to do is center that right on that bar. Okay, and now if we print this, we would get something that looks like this. So get a good shot of that. All right. Now we'll take that off and then pretend this is a blank block. I've already carved on it, but just pretend it's blank. If we stick that in there, and this is wet ink, and we put that down, align our lines here, and run it through the press, then when we pull it away, we'll know what to carve out. In this case, I carved out my little creature here. By the way, let me do a disclaimer. Get a good shot of those. This is not art. This is a demo thing. So it's a questioning hippo saying, am I real? Well, maybe it is art. I don't know. Okay, so that way we get all the information transferred to that block. And we carve this all out, and then now today we're going to be ready to print our first color using this system. Now, because we did mark all these other sheets with a top and bottom mark, whenever we place this, it'll always be placed in the right place. Get it as smooth as possible, lifting up a little bit of that wax there, and you really don't need a whole lot for an addition. That'll probably do it. I think that if you go with a fiery red, it usually turns pretty orange. I could show you how to do what we call a split fountain or a rainbow roll with white. Ink has what we call viscosity, which is essentially a fancy word that describes the consistency, the viscous or the tackiness. See, I'm having a devil of a time making that mix because this is actually feels a little thicker than this. And the way we make that work is we take a little bit of linseed oil. So we'll put a little oil in there and do this thing. How much oil do you put in? Well, there's no real formula. You just want to get this consistency, like that consistency. get it as close as you can. And so the oil is going to thin that ink out a little bit and make it a little closer to the viscosity of the other ink. It looks like it's blending a lot better now. And you have to really work this ink. If I had more time, I'd work with the modification. There's another thing you can do to it that'll also help break down that inconsistency, and that's to add a chemical called magnesium carbonate, and it's in here. So this actually will make your ink a little less tacky, I guess is what you call it. It'll actually make it separate a little bit more and allowing this stuff to mix. So I'm going to show you how to mix that in there. It doesn't take a whole lot. And I probably should have done this at the beginning, but what I'm trying to do again is to get this ink on this side kind of like that one. Anyway, you keep working this thing and it's going to get really smooth, theoretically.
You're more concerned about the blend on your roller than you actually are on the table, though, aren't you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But usually your table is going to reflect like the roller's doing.
I don't know, the roller looks
Yeah, the roller looks a lot good.
Oops. These smaller blocks are much more difficult to work with. Now, you want to get this, keep it as thin as possible, but yet get good coverage. Let the weight of the roller do all the work, though. All right. I think it's skipping a little bit in the red, and that's probably because the oil is a little bit too much there. I think if I had more time, I'd probably put more magnesium in there.
So oil thins it down, and magnesium...
It kind of breaks down the tackiness. Yeah. And you use those to modify the ink so you can kind of get them kind of close together. And it's all in a matter of feel. There's no magic formulas or anything like that. I think that's probably as good as we can get it. Did you get a good shot of that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I think that'll work.
I like it.
If you get ink inside the cutout areas, what usually you have to do is actually cut back into those to remove the ink. You can just stop your process, clean it all out, and then once you clean these blocks, what you have to do is run it through the press with some newsprint a few times and soak the oil back out of the block. And usually it's a good idea to wait 24 hours before you use it again.
I wouldn't learn.
There you go. You want to roll that in half?
Okay.
Lee?
Go for it.
I trained
it
all on my Tuesday.
Thank you.
too bad.
That's pretty good.
It's a little low.
A little low, meaning?
It's coming down too far, but it's okay. Guys, look at this. Look how these little specks really add to the how this is unified.
I don't like it.
That's okay.
Well, Debbie Downer.
Debbie Downer.
But that's how you do it. Now, this would look a lot better once the black is on top of the red, but since it's got the other way, you can see what I'm talking about, how it doesn't feel as finished. Yeah, exactly.